Captain's
helm! Captain has the helm!
Unfurl, mates! Let's move!
Raise those sheets! Let's move!
Spread our wings to the wind!
New sail! Without all she'll take!
Jumps the hill with a slippery tail! Climbs up aloft and reefs the topsail! Stormy weather, boys! When the wind blows, we're all together! Jolly sou'wester, boy, steady she goes.
And then up jumps the shark with his nine rows of teeth. Beat the dough or the dining.
Cargo there, sir.
Waiting on to the yards off the wind.
Enough cargo to approve the ship.
They're awfully close, sir!
Close down! Catch some wind!
Sir! Four!
Let the waters roar, Jack. Safe and sound at home again. Let the waters roar, Jack.
Long we tossed on a rolling main. Now we're safe ashore, Jack. Don't forget your old shipmate. Rolly, 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 ride on.
Since we sailed from Plymouth Sound, boy is gone a night, Jack. Was there ever chummies now, such as you and I, Jack?
There's a blizzard, Captain!
And catch them!
Fire! Words of dancing master, old Billy Riley, old Billy Riley.
Fire!
Old Billy Riley,
get them along! Don't song same!
Billy Riley.
Thank you. captain has the wheel.
Mates out! Let's go!
There's the city of Arkansas, the greatest frontier town of all.
You're here. Congress is still in session. George Washington and his militia have fired on French troops under Jumonville. The French are calling it an act of war.
George Washington. You mean Lawrence's younger brother?
Yeah, it's the same. Speaking of Lawrence Washington, since you eliminated him, James Wardrop has moved up in ranks. All the Templar resources are at his disposal now.
What about the manuscript?
My sources in New York confirm that Wardrop has it. I also learned that he is here at the Congress under heavy guard.
Shay, find Wardrop. Get that manuscript.
This place is thick with Templar troops. Liam and I will make sure he doesn't escape.
Stop, I tell you.
Thank you.
That must be the Templar William Johnson. Perhaps he has the manuscript, or knows where it is.
As I have stated previously, I believe we need a national union, granted by an act of parliament, but bringing greater independence to our colonies. The French are an immediate threat, and we are ill prepared to face them. To put it bluntly, the colonies must join or die.
A rousing speech, Master Franklin. But do you truly believe Great Britain will grant her colonies autonomy?
They have little choice, Master Johnson. You know the remoteness of this frontier better than most.
Yes, but let us leave politics for another day. I wanted to thank you for your research.
Of course, of course. In the brief time I could examine that box, I could tell it was something unique. From ancient Egypt, you said? Well, as I mentioned in my letter, I am quite ready to electrify it.
Excellent. We will have the box delivered shortly. As for the manuscript, Captain?
I apologize, sir, but Master Wardrop refused to hand it over. He said the risks were too great.
The risks? Ah. I apologize. You will have the manuscript and the box in the briefest of delays.
You mind the excuse for a uniform? Run to Fort Frederick and tell Master Wardrop he had better cough up the manuscript post-haste, else I will have him scalped.
I can't let that lobster captain reach Wardrop.
It depends on King George.
I think we need a stronger colonial government.
Down now. I'll take that, you Templar dog.
No! You have no idea what you're doing, fool!
Keeping the people free from your control.
How free will you be when the French undermine these squabbling colonies?
These colonies would be far better off without the Templars pulling the strings.
We bring order from chaos. If everything is permitted, no one is safe.
Even the devil can quote scripture to suit his own purposes.
We will run him down.
I tripped.
Some sort of cargo that...
shipwrecked cargo here, sir!
Batten that down, crystal light.
Enemy heading for us, sir! It's a brig! Royal Navy! They're all alone, sir!
Gallants and royals! Get me some speed!
Now, crystal light!
All down! All down! Cliff ahead, sir! Douse all but mates! Stunts out! Let's get moving! Haul in the studsail!
You're late. This guy is getting temperamental.
That's not the only thing, is it? Master Franklin, sir. My name is Shay, and this is my associate, Hope. William Johnson told us to give you these.
Ah. Thank you, but I'm afraid I must delay my experiment.
Delay it? Why?
The army confiscated my lightning rods. They are essential to conducting the electricity I need to vivify your box.
Master Johnson would not want you to have to wait.
Perhaps there is something you can do, then. Soldiers have been hauling things away all day. Perhaps they could tell you where they've taken my lightning rods so you could get them back.
At your service, sir.
Begin your investigation at the market near the docks. I will stay here and help with the preparations.
This is intolerable. I can barely conduct my research.
You know where the warehouse is.
I'm sure you're seeing things, but I'll take a butcher. In Benjamin Franklin's garden.
I keep well clear of that place. They say that man messes with lightning.
Speaking of lightning, I reckon there's a storm coming.
Aye.
Hey, darling. You up for a pint?
Sure, if you bring your mates.
That's bleak.
Is that the last of it?
Yes, it is, sir.
Good. Put it with the rest.
Hey, get up! What's wrong with you?
I wonder what Master Franklin plans to do with these rods. The storm's getting worse. Very bad for Franklin.
Sherry, thank goodness! Quick, help me with the rods!
The map! Where is that?
Portugal! Lisbon, I'd stake my life on it!
Make yourself scarce, Jay. The militia will be here any minute. I'm sure they will have questions.
What about you?
I'm a devoted housekeeper.
Right.
Mount Vernon. Hope will be expecting me.
This message is sponsored by the East India Company, importers of fine cotton. Customer recommended. Induced vomiting. Opium. Use of herbs.
That's the way!
Don't wait!
There.
Yeah.